Helena Kowalska was born to peasant but religious parents on 25 August 1905 in Gogłowiec, Poland. She had some schooling and felt called to a religious vocation early in her life. However, being poor at the age of 16, she began work as a housekeeper. During a dance that she attended with her sister, Helena, age 18 and a half, had a vision of Jesus suffering and saying to her, "How long shall I put up with you, and how long will you keep putting me off?" Although her parents had refused to give her permission to enter the convent, Helena took a train to Warsaw, determined to enter the convent. She eventually found a convent that would accept her, but only if she could pay for her own habit. Thus, she had to work for about 2 more years as a housekeeper before she entered the congregation of the Sisters of Our Lady of Mercy. On 30 April 1929, she took the habit and was named Sister Maria Faustina of the Blessed Sacrament. In her diary, which is quoted here, she would write of messages that she received from Jesus. Her confessor, Father Michael Sapoco, who was himself beatified in 2008, believed in her visions and began to promote them. Father Sapoco published the devotion to the Divine Mercy and found an artist to paint the Divine Mercy image. Sister Faustina died at the age of 33 on 3 October 1938, presumably from tuberculosis. After many years of controversy, she was canonized by Saint Pope John Paul II on 30 April 2000.
O Jesus, when I consider the great price of your blood, I rejoice at its immensity, for one drop alone would have been enough for the salvation of all sinners. Although sin is an abyss of wickedness and ingratitude, the price paid can never be equaled. Therefore, let every soul trust in the passion of the Lord and place its hope in His mercy. God will not deny His mercy to anyone. Heaven and earth may change, but God's mercy will never be exhausted. Oh, what immense joy burns in my heart when I contemplate your incomprehensible goodness. O Jesus, I desire to bring all sinners to your feet, that they may glorify your mercy throughout endless ages. Number 30. When I told this to my confessor, I received this for a reply. "That refers to your soul." He told me, "Certainly, paint God's image on your soul." When I came out of the confessional, I again heard words such as these: "My image is already in your soul. I desire that there be a feast of mercy. I want this image, which you will paint with a brush, to be solemnly blessed on the first Sunday after Easter. That Sunday is to be the Feast of Mercy." Number 49. O inexhaustible treasure of purity of intention, which makes all our actions perfect and so pleasing to God. O Jesus, you know how weak I am, be then ever with me, guide my actions and my whole being. You who are my very best teacher. Truly, Jesus, I become frightened when I look at my own misery, but, at the same time, I am reassured by your unfathomable mercy, which exceeds my misery by the measure of all eternity. This disposition of soul clothes me in your power. O joy, that flows from the knowledge of oneself. O unchanging truth. Your constancy is everlasting. Number 66. During Holy Mass, my love for Him reached a peak of intensity. After the renewal of vows and Holy Communion, I suddenly saw the Lord Jesus, who said to me with great kindness, "My daughter, look at my merciful heart." As I fixed my gaze on the most sacred heart, the same rays of light, as are represented in the image as blood and water, came forth from it. And I understood how great is the Lord's mercy. And again, Jesus said to me with kindness, "My daughter, speak to priests about this inconceivable mercy of mine." Number 177. Prayer during the Mass on the day of the perpetual vows. Today, I place my heart on the paten where your heart has been placed, O Jesus. And today, I offer myself, together with you, to God, your Father and mine, as a sacrifice of love and praise. Father of mercy, look upon the sacrifice of my heart, but through the wound in the heart of Jesus. Number 239. The next morning, when I entered the chapel, I heard these words interiorly: "A Every time you enter the chapel, immediately recite the prayer, which I taught you yesterday. When I had said the prayer, in my soul, I heard these words. This prayer will serve to appease my wrath. You will recite it for 9 days, on the beads of the rosary, in the following manner. First of all, you will say one Our Father and Hail Mary and the I Believe in God. Then on the Our Father beads, you will say the following words. Eternal Father, I offer you the body and blood, soul and divinity, of your dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, in atonement for our sins and those of the whole world. On the Hail Mary beads, you will say the following words. For the sake of his sorrowful passion, have mercy on us and on the whole world. In conclusion, 3 times, you will recite these words. Holy God, Holy Mighty One, Holy Immortal One, have mercy on us and on the whole world. Number 476.